In this video, part of our Back to Basics series, I'm going to show you how to install DDR4 in your motherboard, and then not only how to install it, but then how to configure it. So let's get started. Now, the motherboard that I'll be using for this example is the Asus ROG Strix B550-F Gaming Wi-Fi motherboard. It's basically going to be the same for any DDR4 motherboard. There will be some differences, but I'll go over that in 1 second. So first off, these are our DIMM slots. DIMM standing for Dual Inline Memory Module. So you'll notice there is DIMM B1, DIMM B2, DIMM A1, and DIMM A2. So B1, B2, A1, A2. B2 and A2, they're essentially one. And then B1 and A1, they're essentially one. What I mean by that is when you buy memory modules, typically they're going to come in a set of two, though sometimes they'll come in a single one. But in the case of two, you're going to be installing them in B2 and A2. So first off, what we're going to want to do is unlock the memory. So to unlock, we'll just go ahead and push this out. And then that's B2. And then this is A2. So now we've just unlocked the DIMM slot. Some will also have it on this left side, but on this particular motherboard, it just slides in. So you notice there's a little line right over here on the motherboard that goes ahead and coincides with the little notch on the memory module. With that little line, if you were to drop in a stick of RAM incorrectly, you'll notice the line's right over here, but the line on the motherboard is right over here. That's not going to allow the RAM to sit properly. So the RAM is not going to go all the way in. It's going to seesaw there. Whatever you do, do not force it in. You'll break that and you might end up breaking a little bit more. So lifting this out and turning it around, we can go ahead and line the RAM in place here. And then we can just go ahead and push down, which will go ahead and lock this in place automatically. That went ahead and locked in, locking the memory in place. That locks right in here. Again, I'll go ahead and just drop it right in here. And now we'll go ahead and do the same with this module right over here. And I'll slide it over a little bit so you can see it coming from over here. I'm sliding it right in the little notch right over here. First off, right in here, and then dropping it in the notch right over here, and just pushing down. And that goes ahead, locks it over here, and then it locks it over here as well. Be very careful when you install RAM that you don't push so hard that you actually end up slamming the memory forward or backwards, potentially damaging the DIMM slots right along here. This is for two modules. Now, there are times when you only buy one module. For that, you would install the RAM in slot B2, right over here, where we installed it in before. And we'll just go ahead and lock this one. Not that we need to, but it just makes it look a little bit nicer. And we'll go ahead and take this one out. Now, there are times when you'll be buying four sticks of RAM. One would think you just drop them all in, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you're good to go. You have to make sure, like we did before on B2 and A2, that you have the matching sets all together. For example, you'll notice right under here, and it's going to be different on every single memory module, but for example, on the G-Skill Trident Z Neo, for example, right down here in very tiny font, we'll see ending in 295. That's actually the date and lot code. Now, grabbing another random module, we'll see right up here, this ends in 294. We got lucky on these. These are matching. But for example, if we have 294 over here, and then we have 296 right over here. These may not work together. They're typically programmed together in a set of two, or if you're buying a complete kit, all in a set of four. If you already have a kit of two, and later on you're going to buy another kit of two, and then you're going to build your machine. You have to be incredibly careful that you match up the different types of memory. So for example, like I showed you, we install the memory in B2 and A2. So what you're going to do here is you're going to grab 294 and then 293. Put these two, this one on B2 and this one on A2. And then you're going to grab 296 and 295 and install this one on B1 and this one on A1. That way you have these two on one channel and these two on another channel. Now, some of you may already have four modules working together, even though they may not be on the same bank, and chances are they will work, but there are occasional chances that they won't work, and they will work better once you match it up the way I mentioned here. Also, on top of that, they're going to work much better once you tighten the timings, enable XMP, and do different things like that. So once you're playing with XMP settings and tightening times, you're going to want to make sure that everything is perfect. Now, you're asking, what is XMP and what are timings? Well, for that, I need to bring you over to a machine. So let's go over there real quick. You'll be able to get into the BIOS by hitting the delete key, F2, whatever your motherboard requires to get into the BIOS. Then we'll come into advanced mode. Then we'll go to AI Tweaker, and mind you, it'll be different in every single motherboard. But for example, you're going to want to make sure that your RAM supports XMP profiles. XMP profiles are great because they automatically set everything for you. So for example, under AI Overclock Tuner, this is an ASUS board. We'll click Auto here, and then we can select XMP1, Extreme Memory Profile 1, or Extreme Memory Profile 2. We'll select one over here. And you notice when we did that, it automatically set XMP to XMP DDR4, 3603 megahertz, running at a cache latency of 16/19/19/39-1. So the lower the latency, the faster the RAM. And then if we go over here to AI Overclock Tuner, click on that XMP, we'll go to 2. Many times it'll have a completely different XMP profile, maybe a little bit faster or maybe a little bit slower. So we'll go back under 1 over here. When we selected XMP profile number 1, we'll go down over here and we'll go down under DRAM timing control. We'll notice it set the cache latency to 16, the RAS to cache latency to 19, the RAS pre-time to 19, and the RAS act time to 39. Now, the one that we saw, the dash one, would be the command rate. We can put that to one end here, but we can also leave it to auto as well because it's auto set to the XMP profile. And this goes ahead and sets everything for you. XMP is going to be just about on every motherboard. The original board I showed you was an AMD chipset for an ASUS board. On this particular board, it's an Intel chipset. In this BIOS, it's called XMP. On the ASUS AMD board, it's called DOCP, Direct Overclocking Profile. Now, aside from that, they're the same. We can go ahead, hit F10 to save and exit. And then easily enough, we'll be back into Windows in a matter of seconds. Of course, depending how your system is set up. But since this is a brand new board, chances are you have to reinstall Windows or install Windows. Now, unfortunately, it's not always this perfect. Sometimes you'll have either faster or slower RAM and you have a perfect XMP profile set, or you have your timing set and maybe the RAM dies, something happens, and you have to replace the RAM, but the RAM that you bought has different timings and you have to adjust things. In order to get that to work, you're going to have to do a little surgery. It's not horrible though. So first off, if it's not already off, go ahead and shut it off real quick. Every single motherboard has a CMOS battery. On this particular board, it's right over here. And I'll show you on the other motherboard in a second so that you get a better idea. The location of the CMOS battery, of course, depends on the model of the motherboard. So what I'm going to do is, on the power supply, flick the power switch off. So now I'm going to go ahead and remove this CMOS battery. Okay. I just pulled it out. I used my nail and just kind of pulled it out of there. Now I'm going to give it about 30 seconds 30 seconds with the CMOS battery outside of the system and no power going to the system erases the BIOS. Now, afterwards, we have to go back into the BIOS and reset everything. I'm doing this in the event that we pop in the memory and the system doesn't post. Okay, what this will do, it'll set everything back to factory defaults so that we can go in and actually enable DOCP or XMP. And then, of course, we'll have to go back in and set all the settings. So I'm going to go ahead and put this back in. Now I'm going to turn the system back on. So now we see on the screen, please enter setup to recover BIOS settings because we've just erased everything. So now we'll hit F1 to run setup, which means go into the BIOS. Now again, we'll go back to F7, advanced mode. We'll go into exit and load optimized defaults. And then we'll go ahead and set all the settings, but the main setting we're going to set now is AI overclock tuner, XMP profile, which again, enables everything and sets everything automatically for us for the memory, the timing and the frequency. And let me just set up the rest of everything real quick to save and exit. And as it occurred before, the system turns off because we've made so many changes in the BIOS. Now that we're in the operating system, we can right click on the start button, go to Task Manager, we'll go to Performance, and then we'll click on Memory. And then here we can see the speed of our RAM. Slots used 2 of 4 form factor DIMM. Mind you, we can use a bunch of different programs to see all of this, but this is built right into Windows and lets us see everything. So in this video, we've gone over how to install your new RAM, be it 1 module, 2 modules, or 4 modules. Then one thing incredibly important is also how to match them up by date and lot codes. That way you make sure not only that you get your RAM working, but you get your RAM working perfectly. Then after we've physically installed it, we went into the BIOS and then manually set it to XMP. That way we don't have to worry about setting manual CAS, RAS, TRAS, and command settings. It all automatically sets it for us, voltages as well. But of course, if you wanted to, you can always do that manually. I showed you the easy way with XMP or DOCP, but after that, that's all on you. So I hope I've helped you in on that. Now, during this video, we did talk a little bit about loading into Windows and everything. And if you have any issues on that, on the video right up here, I showed you how to install a brand new SSD and then how to install Windows 10 onto it. Windows 11 will be just totally the same. Hopefully I've been able to help you. And if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please do leave them down below. I answer all questions. Iggy with This Byte for you out. See you guys.